Hello YouTube! Welcome to my first video. In this one, I'm going to show you how to improve Android 8.0 Oreo performance. The first thing you want to do is to scroll from the top to the bottom and click in the gear icon. This will bring you in the main settings page. Now, what you want to do is click on the apps and notifications and go where it shows you all the apps. Once it loads, what you want to do is you want to go through each of the and one of the apps and click on battery. Below, you're going to see the manage battery usage. If it does not say anything, you don't need to do anything, since it's going to be optimized. What happens is that Android 8.0 has a new management system, and not all of the applications, even the most famous ones, are actually using it. For example, if I go to Bank of America and click on battery, you're going to see that it has a background activity. I already have it turned off because my phone was performing garbagely. I have a Nexus 5X and I couldn't even use YouTube and Google Maps together. So I had to disable most of the apps. Well, it's going to be enabled. You want to just turn it off. I already have it turned off because I apply the performance. And the other thing, you want to go and check through each one of the apps. Generally, the applications that come from Google, you're going to be optimized, such as Google Chrome and YouTube. But you just want to be sure that all of the apps that you're using do not have the background activity. And this one, it has it enabled. I just want it unchecked. I'm going to go back. I'm going to check if Drive has it. And you may be wondering if by disabling the notification, the background usage, it's going to limit the notifications and apps are going to be performing poorly. The answer to them is no, but do not take my word for it. I have disabled Facebook, I have disabled Instagram, I have disabled Snapchat, and so far I've been receiving notifications for them. But you should check for yourself if that does not create any problems. If you just want to be sure, you can just let them activate it and see how your phone is performing. Another thing you want to do while you're in the battery page, in the app page, is that you want to go and click on any of the app, click battery, and then click battery optimization. This is going to bring you to the whole battery optimization page. If you have, you should check that all of your available apps that could be optimized are already optimized. For example, if these two applications or three applications that I'm choosing away right now are not optimized, they're going to show in the not optimized page. And you just want to click on it and click optimized. This will improve both performance and battery life. Another thing you want to do is that you want to go back to the main settings page, which you can do by clicking again the gear icon. Instead, you want to go to the storage portion. Android currently has an ability to free up the space of the phone. And this is important because many of the applications, they save it in what they call the cache, which is like a storage mechanism that allows them to store information that they usually frequently retrieve. It's going to make it easier not to recalculate or refetch it from the internet. You want to click on free up space, choose the items to remove, and in here, you want to also check the infrequently used apps. Infrequently used apps are applications that you do not use very often. Right now, I have them in zero because I recently formatted my phone. And again, it was performing garbage, so I had to perform all the optimizations. But I have currently no unused apps. You just want to click on them and then click on free up space. I don't want to remove the things that I have in download, so I'm all good to go. If I go back, one thing you want to, if you have an application and that single application is performing poorly, you could try either rebooting your phone, which is super important, or going directly to the same application again. Let's say, for example, Maps, and click on storage and clear the cache. You should not do this unless the application is performing poorly. This will not delete your data. This will not delete your passwords. This will not reset the application completely. And But this is like the internal save memory. This is going to get rid of it. And sometimes it gets corrupted, so you could try that. One last thing I'm going to recommend you is that if you use a lot of Google Chrome, by opening it, going to the three dots, and clicking on settings, scrolling down, clicking on settings, you can go to the data saver portion and have it enabled. This is going to save a lot of your data. I have, for example, saved 29.53 megabytes out of the 473 megabytes that I have used. And this may also increase some of your battery life and performance. So that's it. That's the video for this time. If you really liked it, subscribe and hit the bell. Thank you.